While scrutinizing the Presidential Affairs Committee report on the ministerial policy statements of the State House and the Office of the President, committee members were surprised to find 37 billion shillings allocated to Vote 002 State House under Science, Technology and Innovation for Coffee Value Chain Development.
37 billion allocated for support to coffee value chain development. And why this one falls under us, we strongly believe this is a presidential initiative to try and experiment on how best we can ensure that we add value to our coffee so that we can export.
They protested the allocation, questioning the capacity and expertise of State House to dive into coffee value addition and coffee trade.
Then we see the money going into a new office, where we are not clear about the activities, the work plan. Maybe chairperson, help us. Otherwise, chair, I think we are becoming, this budget committee is just becoming a rubber stamp to endorse figures.
We need to scrutinize and understand these things. You can't just go to the president and then money is just dumped there. And in 1 year, where is the infrastructure? Where is the expertise? What are they going to do in the coffee value chain?
Yes.
Lawmakers wondered how funds to develop coffee can go to the State House while the Uganda Coffee Development Authority is starving financially with a constrained development expenditure budget.
Chair, as we talk now, UCDA is completely incapacitated. Their budget has been cut by 80%. In fact, when I see this is a signal of saying we don't need this institution.
The vice chairperson, Ignatius Mudimi Wamakuyu, who chaired the session, revealed that the money is not going for coffee value chain development, as it is alleged, but to the consortium of coffee exporters who courted President Museveni for financial support to supply roasted coffee on the European market and other markets.
So their request was they wanted a loan of $10 million. Because according to their submission, they told the president that they already have orders.
Committee members then asked funds to be withdrawn from Vote 002 and reallocated to the Uganda Coffee Development Authority, which is mandated to develop coffee production and trade, or Uganda Development Corporation, an investment arm of government.
Then it's not supposed to be under STI, either should be under UCDA or UDC.
Attempts by the chairperson of the Presidential Affairs Committee to maintain the budget in State House were thwarted by budget committee members, who insisted that State House has no business with coffee development.
We are aware that issues of research, development and value addition are being handled comprehensively by STI. So that was why we provided a house for this coffee value chain to be under STI. We didn't object.
Oh, no, the coffee is for them to export coffee. Because they don't have capacity, capital. They are not going to add no research on it just to export. And even this one of this medicine you are talking about.
Yes, but how are we going to do our own oversight, because the value chain falls under STI.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.